Hello students, welcome back. Today in this session, we will be continuing with our story quality. In the previous session, I have completed with the reading of the text, and today in this session, I will be discussing about the characters mentioned in the story. Students, remember one thing, to score good marks in your paper, you have to reread the text so that you can quote important keywords and lines from the text. So before starting the session, let us see the objective. By the end of this video, you will be able to learn about various characteristic traits of the two important characters of the story, that is the narrator and the younger Gessler brother. Now let us do the characterization of Mr. Gessler. Mr. Gessler here is the younger Gessler brother. Mr. Gessler is the younger of the two Gessler brothers and the protagonist of John Galsworthy's short story Quality. Protagonist, central character. So who is the central character of the story Quality? It is younger Gessler brother. He is described as a passionate and hard-working shoemaker. Passionate, to have intense feeling for something. So in this paragraph, we are introduced to younger Gessler brother, who is the central character of our story. Now let us see the characteristic trait. His first characteristic trait is his physical appearance. Mr. Gessler has been described as a little, short-statured man, as if made from leather. Statured, refer to a person's height. His face was pale, with lots of wrinkles and reddish hair and beard. Wrinkles, folds or ridges in the skin. His voice was guttural. Guttural means harsh sounding, in conformity with his German origin. So we are introduced to the physical feature of Gessler brother, who is the central character of the story, that he is a little old man, as if himself made from leather. He has yellow, pale here refers to yellow. He has yellow crinkly. Crinkly means to have wrinkles. Reddish hair and beard. He speaks English in German accent. He has been described as if made from leather, suggesting that he was firm like leather but also slow of purpose, that is, slow in execution. Execution means the carrying out of an order or course of action. So the narrator has described that Gessler brother, that is the younger Gessler brother's voice is harsh. He is stiff as leather and slow of purpose, that is, he carry out orders slowly. Now let us see the next slide. The narrator has highlighted the importance of Mr. Gessler's grey-blue eyes by divesting them with the simple gravity of one secretly possessed by the ideal. Gravity, seriousness. This indicates that Mr. Gessler's ideal of being a perfectionist reflected in his eyes. Mr. Gessler's mission in life seemed to make quality shoes as per the demands of his customer. We have done in the text also these lines. So narrator has told that the younger Gessler was made of leather, for leather is a sardonic substance. His eyes were grey blue in color, which had simple gravity, which had simple seriousness, and which showed he possessed the ideal of quality. Now see the next paragraph. Next point is his passion for his vocation. For Mr. Gessler, shoemaking was a sacred vocation. Vocation means profession. Once when the narrator asked him if his work of shoemaking was awfully hard, he replied that it was an art. So from here it is clear that young Gessler considered his profession of bootmaking as an art and is totally dedicated to it. So for Mr. Gessler, shoemaking was not merely a craft but a sublime art, sublime of very great excellence. So I have told you earlier also that he considered his profession as an art. He was highly passionate about shoemaking, as is evident from the fact that he performed all the activities himself, like working on the leather, taking measurements and stitching the shoes. He made sure that shoes made by him were not only durable but also comfortable, durable, able to withstand wear. So he likes everything about boot making, and it is clear from the activities performed by him. Now, which are those activities? Working on the leather, taking measurements of the customer's foot and stitching the shoes. So all these things show his passion for his vocation. Mr. Gessler's passion for his work is also evident from the fact that while making the shoes, when he had to leave his work to attend to the customer, he appeared as if he had been awakened from some dream of shoes, or like an owl who felt surprised in daylight. So he was so passionate about his work that he didn't want that anyone should disturb him while making shoes or boots for his customers. Moreover, he shuts himself in his shop for hours on end and does not come out. He keeps on making boots for the satisfaction of his customer and the joy of his own. Mr. Gessler was a perfectionist. That is why he used to custom fit the shoes according to the needs of an individual customer. So Mr. Gessler was a perfectionist. He always makes sure that he makes the best boots for every client. That is why he takes a pretty long time in making boots according to the specification of his customers. Now see the next lines. He was against mass production in large quantity. He seemed to be so well versed in his vocation that he could tell whether the shoes were made by him or somebody else by simply looking at them. So he was so passionate about his work that he could just see the shoes and tell whether it is made by him or not. And he never allows any leather into shop that is not made by himself. Further, he could make out where the shoe might be hurting the wearer by just looking at them. He was so experienced in boot making that he can recognize where the shoe was hurting the customer. Now see the next slide. When the narrator once went to the Gessler's shop wearing a shoe bought from another firm, Gessler simply pressed his finger on the place where the left shoe was not quite comfortable. In fact, it was his passion for his vocation of shoemaking that he continued his effort to maintain excellence in his work, despite all the hardships, including the death of his elder brother. Hardships means difficulties. So Gessler brother, we have discussed earlier also, he was so much passionate about his work that on seeing the shoe, he could tell where the shoe pinches the wearer. That is why he told the narrator where it might be hurting him. Even the death of his elder brother did not stop him from making the excellent quality shoes. Now see the next slide. Next point is his honesty and integrity. Mr. Gessler was a man of honesty and integrity. Integrity means the quality of being honest and having strong moral principles. He never compromised on quality and excellence, even if it meant more work, dwindling customers, dwindling means gradually diminishing, and profits. So he was a man of integrity. Integrity means principles. He believed in excellent work, whether it may result in more work, diminishing customers and less profits. He always used the best leather and took as much time as required to make a perfect pair of shoes. For him, quality and customer satisfaction was much more than monetary gains. So what matters him the most? Yes, the thing that matters him the most is the customer satisfaction rather than earning profit. Now next slide, children. Once when the narrator complained that the last pair of shoes that he had brought from him creaked, making a harsh, high-pitched sound when being moved or when pressure or weight is applied, Mr. Gessler was quite shocked. He kept looking at the narrator for some time as if he expected him to withdraw the complaint he had made, withdraw to take back. Despite that shock, Mr. Gessler asked the narrator not only to bring back the shoes to him for repair, but also promised to take them off the bill if they could not be repaired. Once, what happened, we have read in the text also, that narrator had complained that the pair of town walking boots made by him creaked. Gessler was not able to take this complaint of the narrator and wanted that he should take back his complaint. And he was so confident about the shoes that it could not creak. That is why he asked him to bring back the shoes for repairing. And if he could not repair it, he promised that he would not charge any money for it. Not only does this show dedication, but also integrity of Gessler brother. Similarly, during his last days, when he was practically on the verge of shutting down his business, he still did not compromise on quality and made the best ever shoe he had made and without hiking the price. Verge, an extreme limit, hiking, rising. So children, as we have read that at the end, when he was struggling for the existence in the days of competition and advertisement, he did not compromise on quality, means he made excellent quality shoes and the prices of the shoes remained same. This shows that he was honest with his work. So children, let us see the next point. Hardships and end. Mr. Gessler lived his entire life in a small tenement, a room or a set of rooms forming a separate residence within a house or block of flats, where he worked and sold his goods. In fact, he devoted his entire life in making best quality shoes. He had to face stiff competition from big firms which had sophisticated machinery and huge capital to advertise their products. Sophisticated, developed to a high degree of complexity. On the other hand, Mr. Gessler did all the work with his hands, from working on the leather, taking measurements, designing and finalizing the shoes as per the demands of each and every customer. So children, we have read in the story that Gessler brother, he lived in a small tenement where he worked and sold the boots. In this competitive world where big firms had sophisticated machinery, latest machinery, and advertise their product, the Gessler brother did not pay heed to it. He performed all the work from taking measurement to finalizing the goods or the shoes himself. He never compromised on quality and always used best quality leather. So what kind of leather does he use? The best quality leather. Although his business was dwindling, yet he continued his struggle for existence without giving into the pressure of competition and advertisement. Where the competition was very hard in big firms and they were advertising their product to increase their sales, Gessler brother did not bother about it, which resulted in diminishing his customers and made it difficult for him to survive in the competitive world. He was forced by circumstances to give away a part of his shop. So, because of the financial crisis, he was not able to manage two shops and it proved too expensive for him. So, the Gesslers have to do away with one part of the shop. His elder brother could not get over the pain of losing one of their shop and died. His elder brother could not get over the pain of losing a part of the shop, and this eventually contributes to his sad demise. Mr. Gessler, despite losing his brother and part of their shop, continued his business of shoemaking with the same commitment as earlier. So here you come to know that they were so dedicated that even after the death of his elder brother, he continued the work with the same commitment, with the same dedication. In fact, his commitment to his work was so strong that he gave himself no time to eat and relax, even when he did not have a penny in the house. So, he gave up everything for what? For boot making. He did not eat, he did not relax, which resulted in his death also. All his profits went in giving rent and buying the best quality leather. So where did his profit go? In giving rent and buying the best quality leather. In his mind, his commitment to do his work and satisfaction of his customer far outweighed his own needs. He finally died of slow starvation. So what was important for him? The important thing for him was excellent quality work, which resulted in his own death, and the reason of his death was slow starvation. He died due to hunger. Mr. Gessler, the artist, died, but his art continued to live through his admirers and customers like the narrator. The artist can die, but his art could not. That is why he still lives amongst his admirer and customers like narrator. So children, this was the character sketch of Gessler brother. So the points which we have covered in his characters are his physical appearance, his passion for his vocation, his honesty and integrity, hardships and end. Now let us see the another important character of our story, that is the narrator. The narrator's characteristic traits are brought to the fore by his association with the Gessler brothers. He was acquainted means familiar with them since the age of 14, when he used to visit them to get his father's shoes made by them. Later on, he started visiting them for getting his own shoes made by them. So, we have come to know about the narrator because he was in interaction with the Gessler brother. He was first sent to the Gesslers for his boot by his father. As he grows up, he is introduced to them at the age of 14 when he himself gets his shoes from them. So the first point of his character trait is quality conscious. The first thing that is suggested about the narrator in the story is that he was a quality conscious man. He had known Gessler brothers from his father's time and knew them as those who never compromised on quality. Compromised, what does it mean? It means acceptance of standards that are lower than is desirable. So the first thing that we come to know about the narrator is that he's a quality conscious man. He believes in high ideals of excellence and quality. That is why he always got his shoes tailor-made, specially made for particular purpose by the Gessler brothers. It means that he preferred hand-stitched shoes by the Gessler brothers. Once he did buy a pair of shoes from a big firm, but that was bought in an emergency. Although those shoes looked fashionable, but the narrator was not comfortable wearing them. Mr. Gessler pointed out exactly where it was hurting on the left shoe. We have read in the story also that he bought the shoes made by big firm. We know this thing that the shoes made in big firm lagged in quality of the product, means they were of cheaper quality. On the other hand, the shoes made by Gessler brothers were excellent in quality. So the person who would be wearing excellent quality shoes would not be comfortable in the shoes which are made of cheap quality. Earlier in the story, the narrator was found to be suspicious about the display of a few pair of boots in the window. Suspicious, doubtful. This even led him to think for a moment that the Gessler brothers might have bought them from outside for display. But the very next moment, he realized that his doubt was unfounded, as Mr. Gessler never compromised on quality and therefore could not have done such a mean thing. So the children, what have we read in this paragraph? That narrator is somewhat suspicious. He begins to suspect whether the shoes made by Gessler brothers are actually their own. So he visits them to verify the authenticity of the boots made by the Gessler brothers. He thinks that the shoes made by them have the quality of being mysterious and wonderful. But he finds his doubt unfounded on realizing the concern shown by Gessler, who declares that he makes boots himself and even does not use leather made by others. Next point is admirer of art. The narrator of the story was an admirer of art and the artist. It is suggested by the fact that he visited the Gessler brothers a number of times as he admired the beauty and the quality of shoes made by them. He seemed to be awestruck, awestruck means impressed, by the beauty of the shoes made by them to such an extent that he described them as too beautiful, making water come into one's mouth. So the children, what have we read here? That the narrator, being an artist himself, is empathetic, considerate and affectionate towards Gessler. He is full of praise for sincere hard work put in by Gessler in making boots using the best leather and keeping in mind requirement and comfort of their customer. So that is why he used the phrases too beautiful, making water come into one's mouth for the shoes made by the Gesslers. He admired Gessler brothers' art of shoemaking as incarnating the very spirit of all footgear. The narrator considered that Gessler brothers' art of shoemaking is done soulfully by them. He felt that such beautiful shoes could only be made by the artist who had seen the very soul of the shoes and who even seemed to dream of boot. He thinks that such beautiful shoes could be made by that person who is so passionate about shoe making. Whenever the narrator visited the Gessler brothers' shop, he felt as if he had entered a church due to its calm atmosphere and the way the Gessler brothers holistically made the shoes. So whenever the narrator visited Gessler brothers' shops, it seemed to him that he is entering a church, as boot making is pursued by them religiously with honesty and integrity. He even seemed to like the aroma of leather shoes, as he would sit calmly on the only wooden chair and inhale soothing smell of leather. Aroma, a distinctive typical pleasant smell, soothing, having a gently calming effect. So he liked the atmosphere, the soothing smell of the leather. It is this admiration for Gessler brothers' art of shoemaking that the narrator not only visited them again and again, but always ordered more than his requirement. So he was so fond of the shoes made by Gessler brothers that he was their frequent customer and he ordered more shoes from them. Let us see the next point of his character. Compassion for Gessler brothers. Since the narrator had been associated with the Gessler brothers for a long time, he was deeply pained by the plight of the Gessler brothers. Plight means bad condition. So the narrator was in long association with Gessler brothers. That is why he was feeling concerned on their bad condition. It can be surmised that the Gessler brothers might be having a thriving business earlier, which began to decline after the Industrial Revolution and the use of advertisements to sell product. Surmised means to suppose that something is true without having evidence to confirm it. So it means that the time before Industrial Revolution, at that time, Gessler brothers might have a flourish business, but the stiff competition from big firms had brought their business on the verge of extinction. Continuing this point, the narrator came to know of their miserable condition only when Mr. Gessler once spoke bitterly about the hardships of his trade, and the narrator was so deeply touched that he ordered many pairs of shoes. From here, we come to know that the narrator was generous by nature. That is why he ordered more pair of shoes. And why he ordered more pair of shoes? So that he could help Gessler's brothers financially. The narrator was shocked to find that outside one of the two little windows of their shop, another name was painted, suggesting that they had given away one half of their shop. So children, due to declining business, it was difficult for Gessler brothers to manage two shops. So they had to do away with one part of the shop. Now let us see further. So out of compassion, the narrator ordered three pairs of shoes, though he needed only two. The narrator had empathy for Mr. Gessler and tried to help him by ordering all kinds of shoes on his next visit, although he doubts whether Mr. Gessler would be able to deliver his order. Empathy, the feeling that you understand and share another person's experiences and emotions. So looking at their declining business, the narrator thought to help them by ordering more pair of shoes. And while placing the order, he was doubtful whether he would get his order or not. Now let us see the next slide. On getting the shoes, the narrator immediately sent a check to pay for the order, as he was knowing that Gessler brother was going through financial condition. So as he got the order, he immediately wrote a check so that they could get money. However, when after a week he visited the Gessler brothers, he got the shock of his life to find that Mr. Gessler had died and his shop had been taken over by a new firm. The narrator had tears in his eyes when he got the news. This shows the narrator as a sensitive man who had compassion for the Gessler brothers. So earlier I have discussed with you that while placing the order, he was doubtful whether he would get the shoes or not. But he got his order and he sent a check immediately to help them. On visiting him after a week, he was sad to learn that Gessler brother had died due to slow starvation, and his shop had been taken over by a new person catering to the royal family and big person. So through these all points, we come to know that the narrator is a quality conscious man. He is an admirer of art. He has compassion for Gessler brothers. So children, I hope that in this session you are clear about the characteristic traits of our two important characters, that is the narrator and the younger Gessler brother. For better understanding, you have to watch this video. And children, remember one thing, that you have to reread the text so that you can quote important keywords and lines from the text. Your homework is to write a brief character sketch of Mr. Gessler, highlighting his wholehearted efforts to maintain excellence in his work. You have to write this question in your copy.